Hey, what's up, guys? This is Fulo with another video. Shoutouts to the whole LGBC. You know, this video is not going to be about boxing. It's going to be about something a little bit deeper. It just, like, kind of hit me hard, you know. I don't know why it hit me so hard, but it just kind of did, you know, that this happened, man. Because I don't think it should be happening, you know. But, basically, a 9-year-old girl in the deep south, in Alabama, she committed suicide. And, you know, it was because she was getting bullied at school. And that's the crazy thing about the whole situation, is that she was able to take her life in the matter that she took her life in. I mean, she hung herself, basically. And, you know, this resonates with me and hits me kind of hard due to the simple fact that it's a black girl, you know. And basically, suicide should be the last thing on her mind. You know, that should be the furthest thing from her mind. Killing herself should be very far from her, but apparently it isn't. And the reason that was, it's because of the simple fact that she was getting bullied. And to take it a step further, the bullying was racially motivated. Slurs like black, B-I-T-C-H, you're just an ugly black, why don't you just die, were uttered. And unfortunately, you know, that got in her psyche and she took her life. Now, the other issue, the deeper issue, is the fact that this was her second school that she went to because she transferred from the first school due to bullying. So the fact that this is the second school that she's gone to because of the same thing from the first school means that there's a deeper need not being addressed. And the parents have actually said that, you know, the schools weren't doing enough for that, you know, because they said that she was being bullied for the whole year, you know, with the same kind of things being said to her. The fact that it goes on for a year, the fact that it goes on for a day, goes to show where those schools' priorities are, you know. And the parents have went on record to say, you know, our trust was with them in the schools, that they would do the right things. And it just feels like to me that they haven't done it. Now the police are under investigation, or are doing an investigation about it. And I mean, chances are they're just going to conclude it and say it was suicide and not say that it was racially motivated or anything like that. But it just shows that, like, that the system is broken. It shows that minorities are still treated as such, no matter what. And it goes just to show that minorities more than ever should try to homeschool their kids so they can instill good things into their kids and instill a sense of self into the kids, a sense of knowing where they come from into the kids, a sense of where they can go with the right know-how and the right tools, a sense of reality into the kids to let them know what kind of world they're living in right now. Although I don't have kids myself, I know that if God does bless me to be a father, that I know I'm going to have to instill my cultural values in them. We call the cultural values on my end Pulavu, and they consist of a lot of things, but that's for another video altogether. To like go over Pulavu would take a long time. But this shouldn't be happening, you know, and it just kind of hit me hard. I don't know why it hit me hard, but it just kind of did, because the girl looks so innocent. The girl looks so, you know, just full of life. And there shouldn't be any reason why she would do something like that, you know. But again, it just goes to back to the school system too, you know. I mean, if I were a principal and these notes were being passed around saying these kind of words, then those kids get kicked out the school, you know, off top. They would have to get kicked out, you know, because what needs to be said is those words may have turned to action. Who's to say that those kids wouldn't have like put their hands on the girl, you know? But I don't want to keep on going on and on. I just, you know, want to say thoughts and condolences to the Adams family. The girl's name was Mackenzie Adams. And, you know, may the Most High give him patience in this time of loss. And that's all I got for now, guys. Leave your thoughts, your comments. And until the next one, Jaramah.